welcome to AP Economics, the video course. Today we're going to talk about the effects of price floors on a perfect competition market. Let's look at our first graph.
Oh my god, this paper I'm writing on is so boring, I'm going to literally die.
Has this ever happened to you?
You're trying to draw a graph of a price floor, but that paper you're using is so incredibly dull, you literally died.
Well, fear no more. You can spit in the face of death itself with the paper, the fancy paper, from Paper Incorporated. This artisanal, hand-machine pressed, fresh organic wood pulp is harvested directly from the most endangered trees in the Amazon rainforest. And now it comes in one amazing color, white, with glitter for maximum pleasure. So I know what you're thinking. This paper looks way too complicated, but it's really very practical. All you have to do is take three easy steps. First, you need some safety equipment. Goggles, gloves, scalpel, body mannequin head, and a banana.
Now just apply the banana to activate the special potassium block.
Set up your standard pentagram shape with a head in the middle, and you're good to go.
See, isn't that lovely? Now you can see very clearly that we've got the perfect competition market for paper, with an effective price floor above equilibrium price. And that's going to drive up the price, increase the quantity supplied, and lower the quantity demanded. That means that we have an inefficiently high quality for our products, and that we have a gigantic surplus.
We have so much paper. Oh my god.
Now for three easy payments of $59.99, you can buy this fabulous paper. You can do anything with this paper. Write on it, play with it, eat it, love it. Never die from boring paper again with the paper, the fancy paper, only from Paper Incorporated, in stores now.
You can get up now. The commercial is over. Are you really dead?
America's saturated in a layer of ignorance. We need to search for the real truth. Today, we're gonna talk about the deficit here on Wake Up America Now! Hey, what's the deficit?
I don't know.
What's the deficit? What is it? Come back here! Hey, what's the deficit?
Who even are you?
Come back here. No! No! You're running from the truth! Hey, do you know what the deficit is?
Yes.
The debt of the United States of America is currently $18.2 trillion. The national debt is caused by the U.S. government spending beyond their budget, causing Congress to spend more money to cover the interest. The United States is constantly running a deficit and spending more money than it receives in revenue. When the government is deficit spending, the GDP of the country temporarily increases through the use of expansionary policy. The current gross domestic product, or GDP, is $17.7 trillion, and the gross domestic product is a monetary measurement of all final goods and services produced within a country's borders, and in a specific time range. GDP is defined by consumer spending, government spending, investment spending, and net exports. Now, consumer spending has the most impact on the GDP, and the government is able to influence GDP through fiscal policy, which includes government expenditures and taxes. Now you're awake, America. The truth is out there.
Welcome back, everyone. This is AP Economics, the video course. I'm the reanimated corpse of Linda Hu, and today we're going to talk about price ceiling. Let's have a look at a graph.
Oh God, I spent all my money on this overpriced sheet of paper. I'm thousands of dollars in debt. And for what? This tiny graph? Oh no, now I'll never be able to pay for college. I'll probably have to live on the streets, poor, hungry, and... Oh no, I forgot to wear the proper safety equipment. I'm a goner. Tell my family I...
Has this ever happened to you? You want to use some paper, but it's so grossly overpriced that you end up thinking about your financial ruin, and you forget the proper safety equipment, and then you literally die.
It happens to the best of us, but not anymore, now that we have cheap paper, the new cheap paper from Paper Incorporated. What happened to make us change our product line? Why, it's a simple thing called a price ceiling. Let's draw a graph.
A price ceiling is a price ceiling is a price ceiling is
a price ceiling is a government intervention in the market that sets the legal price below market price. This increases quantity demanded and decreases quantity supplied, leading to inefficiently low quality and a shortage of the product, which is why this paper is limited edition. Your children will probably never live to feel the smooth, fibrous sensation of paper under their fingertips because you greedy consumers will have used it all. Really, how do you sleep at night, you sick, sick people?
Cheap paper is a registered trademark of Paper Incorporated and liable to copyright law. Do not use cheap paper if you are pregnant or nursing, have a history of arterial disease, or convert oxygen into carbon dioxide. Talk to your doctor about tetanus vaccination, since use of cheap paper may increase risk of infection. Cheap paper may have some serious side effects, such as risk of diabetes, heart disease, chronic scoliosis, smallpox polio, and occult zombieism. Cheap paper is not available in Canada.
Cheap paper, inefficiently allocated to consumers, efficiently allocated to your hearts.
Pollution. It is bad. So why do we allow it? Is it because we all want to die in horrible pain? Or because we love that sweet, musky stench of car exhaust fumes? Surprisingly, the answer is neither of those. The answer is economics. Pollution is something we like to call a negative externality. That means that it's a detrimental effect of operating at economic equilibrium. Much like setting your local grocery store on fire, this is considered a market failure. What are the negative effects of pollution? Birds, probably. Look at that bird. He's probably thinking, look how dumb those humans are, polluting. Ha, you're the dumb one, bird. You don't know economics. But the point is that pollution will slowly kill us all because it causes bad health problems and environmental issues that we won't go into depth about because this is supposed to be about economics. But we sure do love our cars and going places with them. So there's a certain level of pollution that's considered socially efficient. Social efficiency is when the market is producing at a level where the marginal social benefit of a product is equal to the marginal social cost of the product. The marginal private cost of pollution for each car owner is constantly beneath the marginal social cost curve for society, meaning that the market produces too much. So we want to internalize the externality. How do we do that? Why? Through a Pigouvian tax, of course. The Pigouvian tax, named after the economist Arthur Pigou, is the idea of imposing a tax on a certain action or product in order to shift the marginal private cost curve up to the marginal social cost curve. Much like doing community service as punishment for burning down your local grocery store, this is a form of internalizing an externality. Since marginal private benefit is already equal to marginal social benefit, this tax will bring the market to social equilibrium and slightly postpone our inevitable carbon emission-fueled self-destruction. When Keynes said, in the long run we're all dead, he really meant it. Ah, good old crushing realization of our own mortality. What a riot, am I right?
Well, Welcome back, everyone. This is AP Economics, the online course. I'm Linda's evil twin, Glinda, and today we're here to talk about monopolies. Let's look at the graph.
Ma'am, I'm afraid you have to leave.
I'm sorry?
Paper Incorporated just went through a merger with Monoport to become Monopaper Incorporated, the new paper monopoly. You're fired.
No, please, you can't do this. I have a wife and three children.
I didn't do it. The market did.
Has this ever happened to you? Your job at a paper company has just been terminated, and your good friend is dead for the second time. Your wife and three beautiful children are left to fend for themselves. Classic, right? Well, now thanks to the formation of Monopaper, the paper monopoly, that dream is becoming a reality for hundreds of workers. But what exactly is a monopoly? Well, it's simple. A monopoly is the only firm in an industry, either due to government support or natural economies of scale. Monopolies, unlike perfect competition markets, have price-setting power. Let's take a look at our graph.
We face a downward-sloping demand curve because we are the whole industry, so we have to lower prices to increase quantity. We find our profit-maximizing output at MR equals MC, but then we can raise the price all the way up to the demand curve, since that's how much people are willing to pay and are able to pay for our sweet, sensuous, monopolistic paper. If a perfectly competitive firm were to raise prices, they would go out of business. As a monopoly, we can make a profit in the long run, so long as the government doesn't intervene in our evil scheming.
Stop right there!
My arch nemesis, the Trustbusters!
Profit-maximizing prices are causing deadly loss to society!
We demand you produce that socially efficient level of output, where MC equals D!
Cameron, we would incur an economic loss. We'd have to be subsidized.
We can't let you keep overcharging and underproducing. You have to stop!
Oh yeah? Under whose authority?
The authority of the law!
Damn you,
trespassers!
We won't catch it yet!
Shoot, we'll get it though. It's our mission. Sorry, Lindo. We'll have to carry on the mission without
me. Oh no. You handled the paper without the proper safety equipment.
It was my last day before retirement!
You were the best cop I ever knew.
Thanks, kiddo. Now, get out there and save the day!
No!
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Nothing you say can change my mind. You're going down.
But I'm your father.
That's impossible. My father died trust-busting monopolies, just like Michael and countless other agents.
I was experiencing diminishing marginal utility, so I moved to the dark side.
No, it's impossible. Dad? Son!
Do you see that? Blatant nepotism in our government agencies. We can't trust anybody anymore. The whole world is corrupt. That's it for Wake Up America now. Good night. Though you're probably already asleep.
Won't you come see about me? I'll be alone. Dancing, you know it, baby. Tell me your trouble.